TKCK Wave. Yes, this little IEM surprised me when I did the first impression of it. It is $35, and when I put it on for the first time, I listened to it and I was like, this actually sounds nice. You know, I'm getting really kind of tight bass line. I like that. I'm getting some treble energy, some treble hits and sparkles, and I kind of like that. It's relatively well tuned as well. Vocals are kind of nice, and overall, it just kind of surprised me being $35. And the IEM that comes to mind right away when I heard this is the Heart Mirror. And if you guys know the Heart Mirror, I really like that one. And a lot of people in the community can vouch that the Heart Mirror is a really good IEM. And I would say that these are pretty much alternatives to the Heart Mirror, and even better than the Heart Mirror in some ways as well. So in this video, let's dive right into all of those in details on why I like the Wave so much and how does it compare to the Heart Mirror. Hey friends, Timmy, welcome back to another video on Giz Audio. And yes, I'm in a garage today because it is late at night, and filming by the pool late at night, it's just too dark. Yeah, it's really just too dark. So not gonna spend too much time on the whole packaging bit of this IEM. It is a $35 IEM, so you're not gonna get like, you know, amazing accessories, top of the line, whatever. The cables is not gonna be super nice. By the way, the cable is kind of like, I don't really like the cable all that much, but yeah, $35. You're not expecting top class accessories. So let's move on from that. On to the sound, starting with the bass. The first thing you're gonna notice about these bass, and oh, by the way, this is a DD plus BA. So one dynamic driver plus one balance armatures. Now, the one thing you'll notice right away in the bass is that it feels tight. Like it comes across like, I wouldn't say it hits super aggressively or it hits with any like distinction. It's a little bit on the blunt side, but it's tight, you know. The decay is a little bit shorter on the bass, so it comes across like very snappy bass, very dynamic bass, if you will, and it's fun. If you listen to a lot of like metal, if you listen to a lot of EDMs, the bass here would just like, you know, makes you wanna move around because it has that kind of impact. It has that kind of short disbursement that makes the bass just comes across jumpy, snappy, fun. In terms of power, it's not gonna have the most power. It is quite a neutrally powered bass, if you will. It's not the most, I would say, aggressive, strong bass out there. So for bass heads, I would still say look elsewhere. Even though the bass here is nicely done, the power is just not there for a lot of bass heads out there. But for normal people, the bass power on here is just fine. Sub bass wise, these don't really have that much sub bass. Like, I wouldn't say it has any sub bass at all in comparison to the rest of the sound. I think it's really drowned out by how bright these can be. We'll get into the treble area a little bit later. But yeah, in conclusion, the bass is tight, it's really snappy, but it's not as powerful. It's more neutral powered. Still good though, I enjoy it. On to the mid-range. It's good, I like it. It has a sense of clarity. There's a little bit of veiledness, just a little bit of veiledness from the bleed of the bass, but just ever so slightly. For $35, I can forgive that 100%. Now, I would say one thing is that the mid-range can come across a bit thin at times, and that has to do with how much you get in the treble area or how aggressive the upper mid range can come across at times. It just makes the sound comes across slightly a bit thin and even on the tinny side at times. I would say if you're sensitive to treble and if you're sensitive to upper mid range in general, I would say that these might just be a little bit too forward and a little bit too aggressive for you. Now, I say forward, but I don't think it ever touched the area of being shouty. I don't think it ever reaches shouty territory, because I remember some shouty IEMs, and that being the Moondrop SSR SSP. Those are shouty. Now those upper mid range will burn a memory in your head. It's shouty. But these, they never come across like that. But they are forward, they are energetic, they are aggressive, but they're never shouty. But for some of you guys who are sensitive, might be a little bit too aggressive for you. For me though, I like it. On to the treble area, and I would say besides the bass, it is the most impressive part about these IEMs is that it is strong, it is sparkly, it reveals some details, some cymbal hits, and all those sparkliness in the song comes across very forward. It just presents all this information and shove it in your face almost. But it's not the most smoothest treble experience of all. It doesn't have that kind of smooth kind of transition, I would say, from mid-range to treble. It is more aggressive, it is more in your face almost, but that makes the IEM just fun. You pair that with the snappiness of the bass and you have a really fun IEM, and I think that fun, that element of, you know, the sharp treble mixed with the really snappy bass, that was the element that surprised me initially, because it just sounds like it's a fun IEM. Like, I don't mind listening to these at all. Like, they're good, they're fun. I would take this on a plane with me. You know, it's just one of those IEMs that just has a bit of a, I would say, a wow factor, if you will. Now, a lot of IEMs that comes out on the market nowadays, a lot of them lack that kind of wow factor that really grabs you or really makes you think that, oh, this IEM is unique or stuff like that. This one has that bit of wow factor, and that's what got my attention in the first impression, and I think that's what's gonna get a lot of you guys' attention as well. So yeah, treble, although not the most smoothest treble experience, some wonkiness every now and then, but it is forward and it presents a lot of information towards you that some of you guys might not even know was in the song in the first place. Yeah, it's quite aggressive like that, but I like it. Now on to technical performance, soundstage, imaging, and overall details and resolution. It is a cheaper IEM, so it does come across, I wouldn't say the most details or the most resolute out of a lot of IEMs out there. Unfortunately, it is averagely done details for the price. So bring up my scale, it lands, I would say, right around the Blonde 03 area, maybe a little bit ahead of Blonde 03. I would say right in the middle between Blonde 03 and the Starfield. So it's not the most well-resolving IEMs out there, but it's 35. So that's not what I expected out of these anyway. Imaging-wise, it is just, I would say, average to below average. You can get instruments like left and right, but in terms of depth, you're not really gonna get depth. In terms of, you know, grandeur and height, you're really not gonna feel it all too much. I would say it has more width than height though, but imaging-wise, it's just okay, it's average. But for 35, I'm not expecting spectacular technical performance altogether. So details and imaging, I'm fine with that. Soundstage is, you know, I would say like wider than your typical IEM, which is nice. It's not the widest, it's not impressively wide, but at least it's not super narrow. I'm glad it's not super narrow. It's at least a little bit wider, so I appreciate that. All right, so now for the comparison between the Wave and the Heart Mirror. I would say the Wave just comes across more fun. It is more snappy, it's more fun. It's just overall, if I were to pick between the two, I would pick the Wave. If I'm going out and about and I'm up, you know, in the morning, I'm just trying to have fun, I'm trying to wake up, and, you know, I want some fun energy in my life, then I would pick the Wave. The Heart Mirror is going to be for more relaxation purposes, I guess. It really doesn't have any kind of snappiness in the Heart Mirror. The Heart Mirror just comes across smooth, blunt is smooth in a way, but it is more well-tuned and, like, you know, smootherly done tonality than the Wave. But if I were to pick just one though, I would pick the Wave. It's just more fun. It has more of that kind of wow factor. And I love, 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 love the treble that comes across on the Wave more so than on the Heart Mirror. Now, the Heart Mirror does have really good treble. Again, don't get me wrong. They're both like really good. They're interchangeable. They're it's either one or the other. They're alternative of each other. But if I were to pick one, it'd be the Wave. Now, personal feelings aside, just personal feelings aside, not counting my preference or anything, to answer the universal question of which one is the better IEM, I would say the Heart Mirror is slightly bit better. Yeah, as an IEM as a whole, not counting my taste, the Heart Mirror is slightly bit better, but you're talking by like a very small margin. So yeah, just for those who are curious. All right, guys, that is it for this video today. Thank you so much for watching. And if you made it this far into the video, The subscribe button is down there. I would love it if you click subscribe. I post videos very, very, very regularly, and I would love you guys to come along for the journey. And with that being said, I'll see you guys in another video. And if you catch this video early, it's not $35, it's $30 as of Black Friday, so you can get it even cheaper, which is really, really nice. It's already good for $35, but for $30, it's even nicer. So yeah, with that being said, I'll see you guys in another video. Peace out, guys. Bye.